you know, that's a kind of a nerdy experience. So everyone here, they're kind of nerds. So we all have that whole biology, math kind of spectrum in our head that we like to communicate about.
During the morning of the day, it's the biology. And then afternoon, it's like putting what you learned into the robotics.
All of our engineering things that we did were based off of the senses. So for smell, we did the termites were following a line, our robot had to follow a line.
We're hoping to build the robot and then use sonar and make it travel through different obstacles.
So like if there's like a wall, you use sonars to locate that wall. If it's like less than 25 centimeters, it will stop.
Okay, so what we are doing is we're bringing in high school students to teach them about biology, about engineering.
So we have high school students participating in hands-on activities related to biology and engineering, specifically sensory biology and robotics. This program is at the interface right between two really broad disciplines. I think it's important for them to start thinking about connections between fields. I think it will position them well for the future.
When you ask kids about science, they think about science in different fields. Like I'm going to study either engineering or biology, or I'm going to do something in the medical sciences. And nowadays, I've got the feeling that the edges between those disciplines are kind of vague and overlapping.
As we went further in the course, I realized that like some very like small things like smell or like echolocation or anything like that can be tied in engineering very easily. And I think that was something that kind of opened my mind up a little bit.
When you're sitting there, you're like, how am I going to actually put that sense into here? But then it like actually is like a really nice bridge into it.
I've never got to like go and look at an insect like that closely before. So it shows just like how, like there's so much more like to things that you like don't know.
Exposure is the key to STEM. When the students see this in action, I think that gets them to think about how they can use what we are learning in the classroom and what they are doing to actually help solve real life problems. I watched the professors and I'm like, this is really how we should be teaching. I told my colleague, I said, this is how we should be teaching in the high school. You could tell me, but then you could show me, you know. So showing them how it really works, I think helps them to think about this career in STEM field.
I think it opened my eyes a lot, actually, because I kind of tuned out like biology and chemistry and all that. I just went straight to like mechanical. But after doing this camp and like talking to other professors and even the professors here, I think I got a lot more like insight on all the fields and like engineering itself.
I know for a fact that I want to go to college, but I don't know what it is I want to do yet. So I feel like this program helped me like explore my options a lot more.
But we had four college professors that were in and out like helping us. Obviously there's going to be some college professors that are different, but the vast majority are going to be a lot like them. They're willing to help. They want you to succeed. And I really think that's going to help me in the future, like now that I know that.
I was going to plan biology being my major, and I was going to go on to try to be a cardiac surgeon when I'm older. So I'm going to go through pre-med school and have to go through like 10 years of college, which will be fun. So coming here, experiencing like college life and how they run their natural lives and getting experience and notes from them, it's a great thing.
Dr. Dieter and I talked a few days ago, and he explained to me that not everyone is always the smartest in their field, and there's like a wide range. So like after that, I was like, well, maybe I can do engineering because that's really what I want to do. And I came in like, I don't know what to do, and I'm coming out with like, I'm pretty sure I'm going to go into engineering.
We are so good!